After six hard-fought games in this round one series against the New Orleans Pelicans, we find ourselves tied at three games apiece, ready for game seven here in New Orleans. Now, I usually show you guys all the elimination games, but I'm trying to speed this up a little bit because I want to get through this kind of quickly. So I skipped right to game seven. I played games, I think, five, six, and seven, and we are now tied at three games apiece. I think I played four, five, six, and seven. I don't quite remember. But anyway, I'm just going to show you guys the game seven, the final game, the deciding game of this series, and hopefully we can take home a victory and move on to round two. It would be our first playoff series win since 2004. It's already our first playoff series appearance since 2004. So let's get right into it. We're going up against the New Orleans Pelicans like we did in game one where we took home the victory. We won by like 19 points that game. And we figured out through this series that their X factors are definitely Andrew Wiggins and Anthony Davis. If we can get them in foul trouble, if we can get especially Davis in foul trouble, because he's going to be covering Horford for a large part of this game. And that's a crafty post player who we feel we can, you know, use to maybe draw some fouls on Davis. And if we can get him out of the game, that would definitely work to our advantage. So here's the opening tip. It is won by Larry Sanders. We are underway here in New Orleans. And you can see it's already 1-0 Minnesota on top. Eric Gordon, though, top of the key driving. And he's actually going to get the and one layup right there in like triple coverage. Great shot by Eric Gordon. Now on the other end of things, Dante Exum with the ball. Pick and roll with Larry Sanders. He's going to take this one himself. And he is so good at finishing around the rim. Even with big men like Anderson Varejão in his way, he's just so good and so deadly inside the paint like that. But misses the layup there, gets his own rebound, and actually gets the and one. So Minnesota off to a quick start so far. 11-7 is the score. Al Horford going to work on Varejão in the post, and I've talked about it before in recent episodes, really figuring out how to use Al Horford on offense. And it's just nice to have somebody who, this is really the first, you know, good post player we've had in the series. So that is definitely a nice change of pace, and if you remember, you know, playing with the Celtics series, we had Hibbert and Sullinger, but none of those guys were great post scorers. So it's a nice change of pace to be able to have a, you know, really solid guy in the post. That, you know, like the cliche that I always use is go down, give me 2 points, and Horford does that as good as anyone I've played with in 2K so far. So 21-11, the score now. We've opened up a 10-point lead, but Jrue Holiday's got an answer with a 3-pointer. He cuts it back down to 7. Now 21-14 is still the score. And now with just about 3 minutes to play in the first quarter, that's a miss by, I believe that's Patty Mills, but Gorgui Dieng there on the rebound, and Dieng, a guy that's emerged a lot in real life, and has really become a good force off the bench for us, an energy guy off the bench. Perfect role for him, now 24-18. Here comes Nelson on the fast break. I'm trying to block this out with Rodney Hood, but I sort of mistimed my jump there, so Nelson gets the layup, and they cut it back down to 4. Now 24-20 is the score. Patty Mills looking for a screen from Dieng. He's going to take it himself there and actually misses the layup, but Dieng again on the offensive boards doing what he does best. Rodney Hood, end of the quarter, no good, and that's going to make it 26-22 at the end of one. So Minnesota off to a good start. Very, very hard for a road team to win a Game 7. Rarely see it. I think the last one that I can remember was the Bulls and the Nets a couple years ago in the first round, and the Bulls won on the Nets' home floor in Game 7. Other than that, a lot of the time it is the home team winning Game 7. A lot of the time it's close for the first quarter and then the home team sort of blows away. Or usually the home team is the better team because they're the higher seed. But 28-25 the score here. Zach LaVine for the three. Actually, that's a long two. He was about a half step inside the three-point line. So 30-25, here's Andrew Wiggins, and nobody picks up Wiggins. So he drives and dishes down low to Anthony Davis, who gets the and-one slam two-handed. And that's going to cut the lead down to 2. We get it back up to 4. Here's a turnover, so we're going to run on the break right here. We got 3 guys running. Exum down to Kawhi Leonard. I tried to get Leonard going to the hoop there, but I'll settle for the jumper. He's going to make that 8 times out of 10. So 36-30. Then here we got a mismatch. Jrue Holiday covering Al Horford. That is just too easy for Al Horford, who, like I said, has become a really good steady force for this offense. 38-30. Holiday driving in, and he somehow gets that pass off to Davis. Davis is the thing this team does really well is sort of the drive and dump to Davis, and oftentimes Davis isn't even open, but when he gets it around the paint, he's really, really effective. So here's a sweet bounce pass to Andrew Wiggins, who slams it down one-handed. 41-38, now the score. Eric Gordon with the ball being covered by Dante Exum, and you can see Gordon just makes one little crossover dribble and then sort of does the wraparound layup shot, getting that one to go. So 43-40, now Holiday with the ball, kicks it out. Now they're going to pass it cross court to Wiggins, who's going to pump and drive, and when Andrew Wiggins gets a full head of steam to the basket, he is very, very hard to stop, as we just saw right there. So New Orleans actually has their first lead in a while, 45-43, but we're going to answer right back with a nice little 18-foot jump shot from Rodney Hood, who is wide open coming off the screen. Now we've retaken the lead, 47-45. Nice block from Gorgui Dieng. Mills out to Budinger, And Budinger's going to finish it off with the two-handed slam. A great sequence right there for the Minnesota Timberwolves. Now 49-45. Here's our Gordon to the hoop. Sweet block by Channing Frye, but rebounded by Johnson. He's going to flip that one back up and in. And the lead is down to two. And that's going to be the score heading into that. Patty Mills buzzer beater. I don't even think he got it off in time, but definitely no good. So we have a two-point lead at the half. Pretty solid performance so far. Our defense has been better than I thought it would be. And really in this third quarter, it turns into a defensive affair. I think neither team scores more than 20 points in this quarter, if I remember correctly. So Holiday with the layup there. It's all tied up at 49 now with about 9.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Here's Eric Gordon bringing it up, trying to give New Orleans the lead back again. Wiggins, again, with the baseline drive, full head of steam, nice little crossover. I don't know why my guy just fell down there, but oh well, 54-52. Horford layup, no good. Gets his own rebound, though, and puts it back up and in. I think that was a sequence where we had, like, I don't know, three or four offensive rebounds that play. But 56-54. Now Horford, you can see Davis still a little bit young and hasn't quite filled out into what a lot of people think he can be with his frame. He's still, you know, only 220 pounds or whatever, so he's really easy to muscle around with Al Horford, and you saw it right there. Now Exum, little reverse layup. Great two-man game between Horford and Exum right there. Creates a nice open layup and a good finish all around. 62-56. Now Holiday with the little flip shot gets it to go. Lead back down to force New Orleans. Not going away. Hanging around. Keeping it pretty close so far. Budinger kick out to Levine. Again, one of those foot in the line long twos. Actually, it's a three. I was wrong. I thought he had a foot in the line there. But 67-260. Shabazz Muhammad driving in. And this was Shabazz Muhammad, although he doesn't make that one. He actually came in and had a pretty good impact right around this time. We were going on a bit of a run. We're up by eight. Muhammad was covering Ryan Anderson and vice versa. Anderson was on Muhammad, which is a big mismatch because Shabazz is definitely too quick to be covered by a slow, flat-footed white guy like Ryan Anderson. So here you go, Muhammad trying to do something. He actually makes a nice pass to Channing Frye down low, slams down one hand, and that's going to give us an 8-point lead. That would be the score heading into the fourth quarter, 75-267. So a late little surge right there from the Minnesota Timberwolves, and we have taken a solid lead looking to advance to the second round for the first time since, like I said before, 2004, when the team lost to the Lakers in the conference finals in the back of KG's MVP season. But here we go, 8-point lead still, just the start of the fourth quarter. Exum looking for a screen from Larry Sanders. He's going to take a little jump shot there. That was actually a good move by Sanders to pull up there instead of trying to drive to the basket because there's already a man down there, and I don't think Horford was going to get out of the way and spread the floor at all there. So it was a good heads-up play by Sanders. Here we go, now 6-point lead for Minnesota. Holiday dribbling it up, and you can see, I don't know why Horford was trying to pick up Holiday right there, but Aminu wide open getting behind him, so he gets the end one slam. Now it's down to a 3-point game. Holiday trying to create something, sizing up his defender, actually just ends up giving it to Varejao, gets a little flip shot to go. So it's down to 1 point now. The Pelicans have came all the way back. Now it's a 2-point game. Patty Mills sort of just backpedals there, escape dribbles and finds himself open, and Patty Mills can hit just about any jump shot within, a 25-foot radius of the hoop, something like that. So anyway, Kawhi Leonard, easy three-pointer right there for him, top of the key. I shouldn't say it was too easy, but we go on an 8-0 run to regain a 9-point lead here, 87-78. Now Kawhi Leonard with the ball. Sweet pass down low to Dante Exum for the one-handed slam. We've been open up a 10, it was 11, now it's 10-point lead. With 3.5 minutes to play, so the Pelicans' back's against the wall right now, trying to mount some sort of run. Holiday to the hoop, cuts it down to 8. Now it's still 8, 94-86. Holiday, once again, doing the ball handling for this team, creating most of the open looks. Not Wiggins, not Anthony Davis, but Drew Holiday right now, trying to take over, and the lead's down to 4, so they're trying to mount a comeback here. Game 7, 90 seconds to play. Eric Gordon, 3, no good. Anthony Davis, rebound, and he puts it back up and in, so 94-92. Pelicans mounting a comeback right now, a serious run from the New Orleans professional basketball team. Gordon out to Holiday, long two, and it is good, and the game is tied. The Pelicans tie it up at 94. Gordon open three, it's no good. Rebounded by Varejao, puts it up and in, and a 12-0 run from the Pelicans gives them the lead with 40 seconds to play. So on the other end, here comes Zach LaVine trying to create an open look, drives to the hoop, draws the foul, and one. And the Timberwolves would tie the game. Free throw, no good. So here come the Pelicans on the other end. Holiday's blocked, gets his own rebound, flips it back up and in, and the Pelicans take the lead with 13 seconds to play. Here comes Minnesota, down low to Horford, it rattles out. Oh, it was so close. Al Horford's shot went in and out right there. So now two big free throws for Drew Holiday. First one is good. If he makes the second, this series is all but over. Drew Holiday, formerly traded from the Philadelphia 76ers for 2 first-round picks, the 2013 NBA draft, now a chance to win a postseason series for his new team, the Pelicans. It is good. A 4-point game, a 2-possession game with 2.6 seconds to play. And now the Timberwolves have all but lost hope. And in fact, they can't even inbound the ball. So a heartbreaking defeat. The Pelicans end the game on, what was that, a 16-2 run and end up winning 100-96. They take home the Game 7 victory. Our offense cannot get anything going at that last part, and we could not stop Jrue Holiday from doing what he wanted on the other end of the floor. So a tough loss right there, a very tough postseason loss, something that can haunt a team, something that can sort of linger with the team even throughout an offseason into next year. So we'll see how this team recovers. But Davis finishes the game with 19 points, 12 boards, and a block. You can see the team stats here. We end up shooting 6 less shots than them, and we were 2 of 13 from 3-point range. That was really where we got killed, although they were not much better from 3. But Horford, 20-11, he did his part. The thing was, we didn't get enough out of Exum and Levine. Exum, 13 points on 12 shots. He really struggled throughout this series, at least to score the ball, and we really missed his offense. So anyway, take a look at the Pelican stats as well. Holiday finishes with 23. I'm curious as how many points he had in that fourth quarter. Davis did his thing, and that's going to do it. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you did enjoy. And Zuz, I'm out. Peace.